Oh, ho, 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 and Merry Bitchmas.
Some motherfucking trap music.
Hi guys, it's James Charles. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. So it is December, meaning it is officially holiday season. No matter what you celebrate, I am so freaking excited. I personally celebrate Christmas. I am so excited to see my family and all my friends and give everybody the cute little gifts that I've been planning out. Ooh, I just really, really, really cannot wait. I asked you guys on Twitter what you wanted to see this week, and a few of you guys said a drag makeup tutorial. I've only done drag a few times, and unfortunately for me, they are all documented on my Instagram page. I mean, we definitely started from the bottom, but now we're here, so it's all good. And I am so freaking happy with how this look turned out. So in honor of the upcoming holiday season, I decided to do this Mrs. Claus-inspired ho 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 drag makeup look. This look was super easy and so glam. You could literally wear it anywhere, like your office Christmas party, going out with friends, opening presents under the tree with your family. Like, this look is like the definition of wearable glam. Side note, my dumbass forgot to say this when I first started. I decided to do my base and eyebrows off camera. It is so complicated, and if you want to see my drag base with covered brows tutorial, just go watch my Halloween bunny makeup. I did everything there. So if you'd like to see how I created this makeup look, trust me, a lot went into it. You're gonna want to sit down by the fire with a warm cup of hot chocolate. Make sure you keep on watching. I'm first gonna start off by taking this angled brow brush from Sigma. It is the E80, and I'm gonna dip into Wine and Dine from the Violet Voss Holy Grail eyeshadow palette. I'm going to be using mainly this palette today for the cut crease. Next, I'm going to take my Morphe M433 again in Wine and Dine, and I'm just going to dip in and start to blend out this line. Next, I'm using my M514 back in Wine and Dine. I'm just going to deepen up that area a little bit. And then once again, using that M441 to diffuse those edges. Next, I'm taking the shade Teddy Bear on my M562, and I'm going to deepen up that crease, and I'm going to concentrate it mostly on this inner region. I don't know what else to call it. And then switching back to that M514, I'm going to blend that out using Wine and Dine. And then just to deepen up this part a little bit more, I'm going to grab the black shade from the 35K palette and my M562. To clean up this line, I'm going to take my Kat Von D Whiteout Concealer on my MAC 242 and just go right under the edge. To begin sketching out my liner, I'm going to use, of course, the Kat Von D Liquid Liner in the shade Trooper. Okay, so I did a very poor job explaining that, obviously. Liner is something that is really personal to every different drag look, and you really have to figure out what shape fits your eyes best. This is the one that I have figured out works best. For me, it's very, like, long and slender. The same shape might not work best for you, so like I said, experiment. But I just did a line from my outer corner up to right underneath the cut crease, and then followed right above my natural eyelid crease, and then I drew it in. Let me get it a little bit closer. Hello. I drew it a little bit past my inner corner, and then I connected it back in. So we got this type of situation going on. Now the wing is all shaped out, I'm going to fill it in using my NYC liquid liner, obviously in the shade black. This is a great drugstore liner and it dries matte, so it'll be perfect for the situation. Make sure when you're filling this in, you get really close up to your waterline too. You don't want there to be like a line of skin between your huge ass wing and your lashes. To start off the lower lash line, I'm going to grab my NYX Jumbo Eye Pencil in Milk, and I'm going to color in my waterline. And then grabbing my MAC 242 again, I'm going to grab the white shade from the 35K, and I'm going to pack that on top just to set that in place. On my M213, I'm going to take Wine and Dine once again, and I'm going to start sketching out my bottom lash line. I'm going to take my M514 with, you guessed it, Wine and Dine, and I'm going to buff out that line a little bit. I'm then taking my M562 in the shade Teddy Bear to deepen up the outer corner. And then finally, just like the upper lash line, my M149 in the black from the 35K, and I'm just going to connect the wing to the lower lash line. I really want to add something to this because I feel like this is exactly the same as every other drag look I've literally ever done. So I'm going to take my Urban Decay Primer Potion because I cannot find my glitter primer, and I'm going to use my Makeup Geek Sparkler in the shade Asteroid to add some glitter tears. Start off my brows, I'm gonna grab my Anastasia brow brush in number 12 and this shade right here from my 35K palette and just begin to kind of sketch them out. And then when I get more towards the front, I'm going to just kind of grab that color and I'm going to lightly fade it in. I really want that ombre effect of my brows, and if I go too harshly, like I just did with that line, we're not gonna get that. And once again, I'm gonna take my Kat Von D Whiteout Concealer on my 242 and I'm gonna clean up right underneath that brow. With that same brush, I'm gonna grab the white from the 35K. To start my lashes, I'm going to curl them. And then for mascara today, I'm gonna be using the CoverGirl So Lashy Mascara. Since I am a man doing a Mrs. Claus look, I figured this would be the perfect equality promoting mascara. To finish off the eyes today, I'm gonna be putting on some lashes and I'm going to be stacking together two pairs from the Makeup Shack. They are in the style Eye Popping and Mad Eye. I don't really have any like actual drag lashes, so these are the biggest ones I could find. I am praying that they work. I just grabbed these Lena lashes in the style Nayona and I cut the strand right in half. So I'm just gonna pop this on the outer corner to add a little bit more volume out there. All right guys, that is one I all complete. I'm gonna go ahead and do the other one off camera or else we would literally be sitting here until Christmas time. So I'll be right back and we can move on with the rest of the face. Bam, there we go, both eyes are done. It is a Christmas miracle. Let's go ahead and move on. My next step is going to be to highlight my face. Now, usually I feel like my drag looks are always kind of like matte. I feel like drag is just like a matte sport. I mean, when you're on stage like performing, the last thing you want is to be dripping your makeup off. But since we are Miss Claus today and we're just gonna be taking pictures and filming this video for you guys, I did wanna add just a little bit of a pop. So I'm gonna go with Artist Couture Coco Bling on my Morphe M501. And remember, you can use code James for 10% off your order this holiday season. And always, but it's a good time to buy right now. I already added blush when I did my base off camera, but I wanna add a little bit more just to kind of blend the highlight and the contour together because as we know, dry makeup is pretty intense, so blending is key, and I'm gonna be using the MAC Selena blush from the new collection in the shade You've Got Me Feeling in my Morphe M509 brush. All right, to start off the lips today, I'm gonna be using the Too Faced Melt and Matte Liquid Lipstick in the shade Drop Dead Red, and of course, we're gonna overline the crap out of them. Okay, the makeup is complete. This is the look. I really, really like how this turned out. I'm gonna go and quickly throw on a wig and some accessories so we can finish up this video. Mrs. Claus is trembling right now. All right guys, and this is the completed Mrs. Claus inspired drag glam, perfect for the upcoming holiday season. I've only done drag a few times now, but I've been practicing a lot and I feel like this is by far the best I have ever looked. I am so excited and I'm so proud of this look. I feel like I could literally walk on stage of RuPaul's Drag Race season 10 right now, audition, and the only thing Michelle Visage would be able to clock would be my neck, not matching my chest. If you guys did enjoy this video, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up down below and subscribe if you have not already. I post videos every single week and I'd love to have you join the family. If you'd like to follow me on my makeup journey, you can follow my Instagram and Twitter. They're both James Charles. By the way, hint hint, I may or may not be doing a full month of giveaways over on my Instagram page. New giveaways every single week. Definitely you should go check that out. And if you want more behind the scenes type stuff, you can follow my Snapchat, which is James Charles, the extra S after Charles. Woo! Since it is a season of giving, comment down below and tell me what you're getting your best friend for Christmas. Obviously, don't say what your best friend's name is because we don't want to be exposed. And tell me the number one thing on your Christmas list this year. I'm asking for a vlogging camera for my parents because I think I'm going to start doing some vlogs for you guys. What would you think about that? We'll have to wait and see. All right, guys, and that is all I have for this video. I really, really hope you did enjoy it and learned a little bit about the art of drag. It is totally different than my everyday makeup style, so it's so much fun to experiment and see what I can come up with because it's definitely not the easiest thing in the world. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you next time, and happy holidays. Bye! Someone just tweeted me and asked why Mrs. Claus is topless, and if you're really wondering, Mr. Claus spent all of our money on presents this year, so unfortunately, the $50 slutty Santa top from Target did not fit the budget. I would like it to be known that these earrings are actually ornaments from my Christmas tree and I glued them on to my ears with nail glue. So when I rip them off, my ears are definitely gonna bleed. Just letting you know that I'm dedicated.